Yes, good morning, students. This lecture is in continuation with the concept we started off yesterday. It was regarding the business letter placing order. So after we have been able to inquire about the service or the product we want to go for, we would place order for that service or we would place order for that product. So when we are placing order, when we are writing a letter placing order, format wise, I told you the things very clearly yesterday. You can go in for the same video of yesterday and you can see what format was there. Okay, orally, I'll repeat again. Okay, so it's format wise, it starts with number one, sender's address. On the top comes sender's address, your address, the one who writes the letter. After sender's address, we write date. After date, we write the address of the addressee. Address of the addressee means the person whom you are sending the letter. Okay, and when you write address of addressee, the designation comes first. The manager, the managing director, the CEO, anything, something like this. So the manager, one designation, the name of the organization, and finally the name of the city where that organization is. If you're writing a letter to the principal of Swami Santa's Public School, what will you do? The principal, Swami Santa's Public School, Jalandhar City, right? After this address of the addressee comes up the subject, the most important segment of a letter, formal letter. So subject is actually the title of the letter. Okay, what is subject? It is the title of the letter. When you write a story, you write a title on the top. When you write an article, you write the title on the top. When you write a report, story or an article, you write the title on the top. But in case of the letter, the title is written in the form of subject, which comes within. Okay, and so the subject should be very brief. Okay, it should be very brief and to the point. So when you are placing order for some object or some service, then you must just simply say placing order for refrigerator or placing order for the computers or the laptops, whatever the object is. So, right? So after the subject comes up the salutation. And salutation is the way we address the person. Okay, if it is the manager whom we are addressing, we would say, dear manager, dear editor, dear CEO, anything, something like this. So the meaning is that when you write the salutation, it should show, it should be very respectful salutation or respectful address to the person whom you are addressing the letter as. After the salutation comes up the content, for which the format I've written here. Okay, content is the body of the letter. What is content? Content is like what we are writing in the letter. Without content, your format is of no use. And without correct format, you won't be able to deliver the right information. You won't be able to express yourself that clearly, right? So both format as well as content, you know, they are part and parcel of a letter. So when we write the content, we must be very sure. We must be very careful that we are able to convey our point of view. So here in this letter where we are going to place order, our main object is to place order for the specified items we want for ourselves. So here in placing order, the list is most important thing. The list of the objects or the list of the services we want for ourselves, right? But before that, we don't start off with the list itself. The first paragraph of this business letter starts with a reference. Reference to quotation dated. So yesterday also I told you, like, this is not the first kind of the letter. This is not the first transaction with the company when we are going to place order. Before placing order, we might have earlier inquired for the things. Then that company might have sent us a reply. Then we might have gone through the quotation or we might have gone through the details which that company sent us regarding their terms and conditions. So when we liked those terms and conditions, then only we are going to place order. So please, children, remember, when we are placing order, then we don't have to tell the company what we want. Then we don't have to set the conditions. Our conditions have already been set. First, when we asked, when we wrote a letter of inquiry, then we asked certain questions from that company. Okay, that company sent us a reply and they told us what their response is to our queries. So most of our doubts have already been sorted out through that letter which that company sent us. Okay, in that letter, they might have also sent us the quotation, or you can say they might have also sent us that catalog, or they might have sent us the details of the terms and conditions of that company. Right? So now we won't be telling us that this is what we want. This is the final phase. We are placing order because we liked the terms and conditions of that company. Okay? We have agreed to the kind of discount which that company will be giving us. We have agreed to the time limit or the time span that company will take to send us the consignment. Okay, so now we don't have to fix the condition that I want the consignment by this date, because it has already been fixed. That's why we are placing order, because everything is finalized. That's why we are placing order in the end now. But doesn't mean that we won't be pointing out what we have already discussed. I'll be telling you what we will do about those things in the end. So when we write the letter, first paragraph is about the reference to context. Reference. What is reference? We tell the Japji is coming too late. So reference to first point in the letter is reference. This letter is with reference to the quotation dated so much, so and so, regarding the order for, regarding the services you want for your company. Okay, reference is earlier you wrote the letter inquiring about something and that company sent you the response and all. And you were very satisfied with the terms and conditions as were stated in that company's response letter. And now you are going to place order. Purpose of writing letter. So now you are going to place order for the services or for the products which you want for yourself. Okay, what's the purpose of writing letter? You are going to place order. Here in the letter, you are placing order. Got it? So then second paragraph starts off with a list or table of products you want to order for. This is the most important part of your letter. So in the second paragraph, there is no need to write anything. So here is a list of the objects or the articles I want. So list can be in the form of a table, right? That would depend upon the kind of requirement it is. So if your list is quite long one, then it can be a table. If it is just one article with one kind of model, with one kind of size or color, then just simple one line. That also can be tabular, but it can be highlighted. Okay, you can highlight it in your own way. So list of the products you want to order for. So here, what is very important, you specify the quantity, whether you want one piece, whether you want 20 pieces, mention it very clearly. Then number, quantity or number, okay? Then you mention the size, model, and even the color. So each and everything must be mentioned very clearly when you are placing order. Later on, when the things come up, there is no scope for you to rectify, then the company will not be responsible for any sort of confusion in the kind of consignment you have received. Third paragraph is about the preconditions. What are the preconditions? One is conditions. What are the conditions for you to get the response? When you want the things, when you want the consignment reached to you, It's not that you're going to fix the conditions now. The things have already been set earlier. So that's why I'm talking about preconditions. So we just have to acknowledge the preconditions. We just have to give them a reminder. Got it? So what kind of reminders are to be given? Regarding timely delivery of consignment. So now you'll be telling that, so these are the things which we wanted. So we are very sure that your reputed company will take care of the, will be very careful about the, about timely delivery of the consignment. So as it has already been discussed that the consignment might reach us by the mid of August. So we are very sure that you will, your company will do the needful. So timely delivery of consignment, or you can talk about regarding payment issues. Yes, as it was already discussed, we will be making 50% of the, that 50% of the payment is being made along with this order, and rest of the payment would be made after we receive the consignment. Got it? It might have already been fixed earlier that how the payment will be made. Okay, some companies take 100% payment in advance, and sometimes they decide like 50% payment would be done at the time of order, placing order, and rest of the payment is made when the order is received. Okay, then you can also give one more reminder, like the regarding the safety of the consignment. So we, as it was already mentioned, as it was already fixed, that your company will be responsible for the transportation of the consignment. So in case there is any damage to the consignment, then your company will take responsibility for it. So these things are already discussed. So you'll be just acknowledging them here. So we are very sure that your reputed company will take care of the timely delivery of the consignment. And moreover, the 50% of payment is being made done, is being made now, and the rest of the payment would be made later on. And thirdly, your company is responsible for the transportation, and if any damage occurs during the transportation, we are very sure you will take the due action. Right? So with this, you know, your letter has almost come to an end. Right? If there is something else, you are most welcome to add in from your side. There might be many more things. But remember, the business letters or the formal letters are usually written in, are usually very concise. They are to the point. Okay? Don't elaborate the business letters too much. To the point business letters always fetch more attention. So after this, your letter has come to an end, then you would leave a few, one or two lines, right? Yesterday also I told you, like, when do we need lines? When do we need lines, children? Roll number 28, Gia, unmute yourself. 28, roll number. Unmute yourself, Gia. Yes. Yes, Gia, what happened? Yes, you are already unmuted. Yes, speaker. Gia, you are unmuted. You speak. Okay, anyways, you try to fix the problem. Then Krishna, unmute yourself, Krishna. But Gia, you are not audible. It's okay. Yes, Krishna Sani, speak up. Krishna. So Krishna is absent. He is present but absent. Okay, Ansha, you give the answer.
Ma'am, Ma'am, when we have completed a segment of the letter.
Yes, very good. So Ansha, your answer is correct. We leave lines when we are changing when there is some change in the segment of the letter. Okay, it is to make the letter look presentable. It is to make your letter or write up look presentable. Okay, the things become clearer when you leave a line. Then the reader comes to know like there are some changes coming up in the letter. Okay, so now after leaving that line, one or two lines, you'll be just saying like looking forward to the prompt action. Okay, looking forward to hear from your side, something like this. Okay, looking forward to, it's a concluding part, looking forward to. Yes, you can write down looking forward to. Looking forward to hear from your side. Write your name, whatever your name is given, X, Y, Z. Right? So with this, your letter would come to an end. Looking forward to hear from you. Yours truly, XYZ. Okay, yours truly, XYZ. Don't write yours faithfully. Yours truly, XYZ is a name. Okay, it can be anyone name which is mentioned in the question paper, or anyone whosoever writes a letter, that person will write his or her name, XYZ. Is that clear? Okay, so here I'm going to show you some letters now. So is it clear, children? Is the screen clear? Letter of placing order. So here is some examples are there. So shall I read them out? So letter of placing order. See, question number one, you are Sakshi or Saksham. Hostel warden, Radha Krishna Public School, Vrindavan, Uttar Pradesh. Write a letter to the sales manager, Bharat Electronics and Domestic Appliances Limited, New Delhi, placing an order for fans, microwaves, ovens, and geysers that you wish to purchase for the hostel. Also, ask for discount permissible on the purchase. So, here is a question for placing order, right? So, you know who is the sender? Who is the sender? It is either Saksham or Sakshi from the Radha Krishna Public School, Vrindavan, right? So sender's address on the top, Radha Krishna Public School, Vrindavan, Uttar Pradesh, right? So here it is a sender's address. This much is sender's address, which I have underlined. After there is a date, 18th May. Then the address of the addressee, the sales manager. This is the address of addressee. Say the sales manager, Bharat Electronics and Domestic Appliances Limited, New Delhi, and then PIN. Right? So this is the format. Those children who often get confused, they can still see on the top the address, the sender's address, then date, then address of addressee. Then comes the salutation, dear sir. So I always say like when you are very sure like who the manager is or something, then only you have to write this word sir. Otherwise you can simply say dear sales manager. That is equally acceptable. Okay, sometimes the sales manager, maybe that is a ma'am, maybe that is sir, we don't know, we have no idea. So we can always say dear sales manager. Subject would be placement of order for electronics. So here the writer, here it's the writer has not changed the line. Subject is to be only replacement of order for electronic subject. Is that clear? Subject is placement of order for electronics. This is only subject. Then the line had to be changed, but here by mistake the line has not been changed. Right? So then the letter will start. We are happy to place the order for the following items. So here the writer has not given any reference, but you should give. Okay? Here the writer, because everybody writes from one's own point of view, but I've given you one format, then you first of all you have to talk about the reference that this hostel warden might have already talked with this manager regarding what she wanted to purchase. So you can say like, this letter is with reference to the letter dated this, in which I inquired for certain electronics and you sent me a catalog and response, and I was very satisfied to hear to know that your company is very offers lucrative incentives to the ones who purchase online objects from you, something like this. So now we are very happy to place the order for the following items. Kindly send the following items at the above address through transport carefully. Okay, so you are to remember your format. What we are reading right now, whenever we go for any other write-ups, when we go for solved examples like this, it's not that we have to learn them. It's not that we have to forget what the format our teacher has given us. The same format you have to follow. These things are only for us to have some more exposure. Okay, for example, you people don't know like how to place, what kind of objects can be there for electronics. Okay, number of item, name of items, number of items, brand. So see the list. Name of items, number of items, brand. So table is there, fans, 50 items, brand Bajaj. Microwaves, 25, LG. Ovens, 30, Philips. Geysers, 25, Nova. So here is a table. So what I want to stress here is, it's not like what you've written, but the thing is how you've written it. Right? Then, all the items should be in good condition, well bound and packed properly. These are the acknowledgement of the preconditions. The items must be delivered by the end of the month of the issue of this letter. Any damage during transportation would be your responsibility. As in the past also, we have never been given any opportunity to complain, and goods have always reached as well on time and in excellent condition as per our specifications. We do expect the same delivery this time as well. Kindly offer us a suitable discount as it has been the practice all these years. So yours faithfully. Is it okay, Nivedita? Unmute yourself, Nivedita.
Yes, ma'am.
Is it okay, yours faithfully?
No, ma'am.
Why?
I'm yours truly, Ajay.
But yours faithfully is not acceptable nowadays. Faithfully means, listen to the meaning of faithfully is, mute yourself. What's the meaning of faithfully? When we say that I'm very faithful to you, it means that whether you do wrong or right, I'll be with you. But it's not so. We human beings are not like that. If somebody does wrong, we don't go with that person, isn't it? So we don't nod, we don't agree with somebody who is wrong. But faithful person is with the wrong action also. The Britishers wanted Indians to be faithful. They never wanted Indians to say no to what they are doing. Okay, because then they enslaved us. Dog is a faithful animal. Human beings are not faithful creatures. Human beings can be sincere, human beings can be obedient, human beings can be true, but being faithful is something else. Okay, this is my personal, it is so otherwise also. So say yours truly. Truly means whatever I've written in the letter, that is true. I will stick to these words. Okay, sincerity is for the person under whom you're working. Okay, when you're not working with the manager of this company, how can you be sincere to him? But yes, with the dealings, you will be sincere. If you have promised to make the payment after the consignment, you will do that. You will not say no to that. So the words like sincerity or being truthful is better than being faithful. Is that clear? So yours truly, T-R-U-L-Y, yours truly, Saksham, hostel warden. Okay, now let's see the next letter. So here is a letter to Delhi Sports, Daryaganj, New Delhi. Placing an order for sports articles like footballs, cricket balls and all to be supplied to your school. Sign as Ravi or Ravina, sports secretary. So here is the address on the top. Happy Time Public School, Bhajanpura. So here is the name of the school who is sending the letter. Then date is there, 19 Jan. Then address of addressee, the manager, Delhi Sports Daryaganj, New Delhi. Dear sir, subject is placement of sports goods. This has reference to the quotation dated 19 December this. So what does it mean? That this letter is related to the quotation which was made on this date earlier. Kindly send the following items at the above address. So the moment you say like this, that this letter is with reference to the quotation. Okay, the moment you give this date, okay, that company will open up the letter of that date and they'll come to know like on this date, what was the quotation, right? Name of the item, footballs, number of items, 10, remarks, Spartan. So remarks over here is the brand, right? So football, cricket balls, tennis balls, then cricket bats. All the items should be in good condition, well bound and packed properly and delivered within a week. So see, the first line is almost the same what it was in the previous one. The payment will be made by cash once the items reach us. Any damage during transportation would be your responsibility. Though in the past you have never given us any opportunity to complain, and the goods have always reached us well on time and in excellent condition as per our specification. We do expect the same delivery this time as well. Yours truly, Ravina, Secretary. So children, now there is third question. You will be doing it on your fair notebooks. First and second, we have just discussed in the class. So today you will be writing in your fair notebooks the complete format of the formal letter, placing order, then one question like this. As the head of the music department of your school, write a letter to the Hyderabad Music House, placing an order for some music instruments like the sitar, harmonium, tabla, tanpura, and guitar. You are Anvita Anil of DIPS School, Rohini, New Delhi. So here is your homework. You can take the screenshot of the question, not of answer, and you do it on your own. Is that clear? It's your homework now. So Tushar has come in the waiting room now when the class is going to be over. So this is your homework. You can take the screenshot. And Anshya, send me the homework also. I mean, like, send me the question of the homework. Okay, children, time is almost over. So do this homework.